Liverpool new goalkeeper Sander Westerveld, who's played in every Premiership match so far. A back four of Vegard Heggem, Jamie Carragher, Sammy Hupier, and a change at left back with Steve Staunton replacing the injured Dominic Mathieu. Vladimir Smitser returns on the right of midfield. Jamie Redknapp partners Dietmar Hamann, the German international, making his first appearance since his ankle injury on the first day of the season. Patrick Berger completes the quartet. And for the first time in 5 months, Gerard Houllier is able to start with his first choice attacking partnership of Robbie Fowler and Michael Owen. For Everton, their first choice keeper Thomas Moura is now back in training, but Walter Smith has been delighted with the form of his stand-in Paul Gerrard. In the back four, Irishman Richard Dunn plays on the right. Michael Ball replaces the injured David Unsworth at left back. And there's Scottish steel in the heart of defence in the shape of David Weir and Richard Gough. The midfield lines up like this. On the right, Don Hutchison, recovered from a calf injury. In the centre, John Collins, a new signing, Abel Xavier, a Portuguese international, with Nick Bambi on the left. And up front, the man whose goals really rescued Everton at the end of last season, Francis Jeffers and Kevin Campbell.
Substitute keeper is number 35, Steve Simonson.
Yes, Liverpool with a 4-4-2 formation. I think the first thing that strikes you is that tonight it looks a rather experimental side considering what's at stake, a massive game against the local rivals. I think that's the first time the back four have ever played together. In midfield, I'm sure that Houllier is welcoming back Hamann, but it's taken a real risk. Apart from 25 minutes of Milton game against Sheffield Wednesday, he's yet to play even a warm-up game. The strength of the side, obviously, is going forward in Fowler and Owen, two outstanding forwards. But at the back, they're looking for a clean sheet tonight. Move on to Everton.
Number 16,
just like Liverpool, solid 4-4-2 formation.
15,
great deal of experience there in Gough and Weir, the two Scottish internationals. They'll be looking to do an experienced job to protect the two fullbacks, two youngsters, Dunn and Ball. Midfield, you've got the versatile Hutchinson, plays a variety of positions. I think tonight he'll start on the right-hand side, but will play very narrow. And if the chance comes to Barnby, he will go and join in the front two. In Xavier, they've got a very aggressive defensive midfield player, and like Liverpool, I feel the strength of the side is up front in Jeffers and Campbell. They've got two outstanding forwards. Jeffers, although not blessed with outstanding pace, shows great movement and a very, very good goal scorer.
Let's have a quick look at the substitutes bench. Onsho, the Swiss international who made his first Liverpool appearance against Hull City last week, he gets a place. Meyer, the Dutch striker, Camara, that Trevor's already mentioned. Young Gerrard, who's been playing regularly recently, and the Danish goalkeeper, Nielsen, for Everton. Two Scotsmen, in Cleland and Gemmell, the former Sheffield United player, Ward. Tommy Johnson, who's just come down on a three-month loan from Celtic with a view to a permanent move, and their standing goalkeeper tonight, Simonson. Well, you don't see that in many big city derbies, but it's always been the practice on Merseyside, even in cup finals, for Liverpool and Everton fans to mingle. The rivalry may be fierce, but it's also very friendly. It might not be quite so friendly out on the field, although there's plenty of handshakes in the tunnel at the moment. Hutchison, of course, a former Red, had almost 4 years at Anfield and has played for both teams in this Merseyside derby. He'll lead Everton out tonight with Jamie Redknapp having recovered from a foot injury, taking the Liverpool captain's armband. Liverpool 12th in the table. If they win, they'll go equal on points with Everton, who are 9th. And if they win, they could even climb as high as 5th place and go above Chelsea. It's the longest running local derby in English football and always one of the most fiercely contested. We can guarantee a great atmosphere, ferocious commitment, excitement and superb entertainment. So stay with us for Liverpool against Everton.
Sky's new digital technology and Go Interactive, that's channel 404. On Sky Sports 1 also, it's the Merseyside derby, Liverpool against Everton, with Trevor Francis and Alan Parry.
Two of the real giants of English football meet head-to-head then, and since they first clashed over 100 years ago, there's been almost nothing between them. 57 wins to Liverpool, 53 to Everton, 50 matches drawn, every single game in the top division, and for the first time in 10 years, Everton go into a derby match higher than Liverpool in the league table. It'll be Everton to get proceedings underway. Four of Liverpool's team tonight have never played in a Merseyside derby before. There are three on the Everton side, and I would think for the first 20 minutes they ain't going to know what's hit them. Perfect night for a game of such importance. Won't be doing well to keep that in early on here for Everton. A layoff by Campbell, a little loose. And Spitzer a little fortunate, I think, that the clearance found a colleague. Everton with their new found confidence. Not only have they had improved results this season, but Evertonians will tell you that the standard of their football has been much higher than in recent times as well. But they know that this is the test their supporters have been really looking forward to. Everton have made their best start for 6 years, and in fact, if they win today, Walter Smith's team will have equaled their best start for 19 years. Xavier, the Portuguese international, one of those tasting the derby atmosphere for the first time, of course. Don has played before. Xavier again, Campbell well placed on the far post. Liverpool have stretched to get it away. Here's Smitsa, the Czech Republic player, back in the side after injury. Redknapp driving Liverpool forward. Staunton, one of the old hands of these Merseyside derbies from his previous spell at Anfield. Patrick Berger leaves the cross to Staunton. Schmitzel teed himself up for the volley. Boupier for Liverpool. Patrick Berger. And the late challenge on Berger earns Liverpool a free kick.
It's just a word on about the two formations, as we anticipated, both playing 4-4-2, but Don Hutchinson, we thought, would be on the right-hand side. He's actually playing central. Xavier on the right. I think that's tactical to try and stop the thrust of Berger on the left-hand side for Liverpool.
Redknapp for them. Another late challenge which referee Riley has allowed unpunished, since Liverpool still have possession here with Staunton. And a little deflection could easily have wrong-footed the Everton goalkeeper. The referee off the ball there, just had a word with Redknapp. He recognised that the challenge was probably a free kick in different circumstances.
Yeah, good play there from Staunton, pushing it through the legs of Dunn, and the opportunity to produce a ball. He allowed it to be blocked, but Liverpool have at least won a corner.
Boupier makes a run towards the near post. Difficult ball there for Everton to deal with. Gerrard has conceded another corner, or has he? No, the referee was about to point to the corner. The linesman indicated goal kick, and that's the verdict.
Yes, that wasn't the best of defending from Everton. Near post corner, it allows Heckham to get in front of Hutchinson. His run wasn't tracked.
Liverpool have lost only one of their last 13 matches against Everton here at Anfield, 4 years ago now. Staunton's clearance. Smitsa didn't know where the ball was, but Liverpool get the throw.
It was an important clearance too from Staunton, because Hupe missed the bounce of the ball, completely misjudged it. But Staunton showing good defensive qualities, coming around the cover.
Everton threatening again. Jeff is well placed in the middle. And a good flowing start to this game. Awkward clearance for Heggham. He's under pressure from Barmby. In the side now after his injury problems, Vegard Heggham, his first choice right back. The ball bounces kindly there for Barmby. Jeffers turns it forward, Campbell's onside! Everton have scored! What a start!
Well, Liverpool were looking across for the linesman, the flag. He didn't raise his flag, but it was outstanding play from Jeffers. Just look at the awareness he shows here as this ball is played in from Barmby. He gets lucky here from a deflection, but just look at Jeffers. He knows exactly where Campbell is. Definitely not offside. Vestervelt certainly gets something on it, but he can't prevent it from going into the net. What a start this is for Everton.
Kevin Campbell had gone 5 matches without a goal, his worst spell, in fact, since he joined Everton. A spell that's been dramatically ended on the ground where his supporters would most want him to end it. Staunton. What a stunning start. And Liverpool's shaken by that.
Well, it's the problem, Alan, that I spoke about prior to kick-off. Just one game this season when they've managed to keep a clean sheet. They've played barely 5 minutes, already they find themselves a goal behind.
Yes, the only clean sheet that Liverpool have managed, ironically, was against Arsenal. And Gerard Houllier, understandably, looking even more anxious now. It's his 40th game in sole charge of the team tonight. And he would not have wanted it to start that way, obviously.
I also said, Alan, about that it's the first time this back four have ever played together. It's quite an experimental back four for such a massive game. And the signs were that they've done little work on the training field because they were all at sea.
It's becoming a familiar problem for Liverpool.
I'm not quite sure who it was playing them onside. I think it was possibly Carragher. They were looking for offside, but quite clearly Carragher was playing them. Campbell 2 or 3 yards, he was onside.
On David Weir has given Everton a free kick in a good position. And perhaps another problem for this leaky Liverpool defence to handle. Goff coming forward to join Campbell and the rest. Making a good run as well. The Liverpool fans thought they should have had a free kick there. The referee thought otherwise. Liverpool show their attacking qualities with Robbie Fowler. That's good skill by Fowler. Just a yard too far in the end. Staunton's challenge. Then a good one from Hutchison. Berger has it back for Liverpool and the usual frantic opening to these Merseyside derbies. But you don't usually get a goal in the opening 5 minutes. First touch I can remember him getting on his home debut, of course. Smitzer. Another German again. It was a full stretch to even control that, and he's lost possession, and Everton looking dangerous on the break again. Campbell and Jeffers in harness. Well, Carragher saved Liverpool then from another embarrassment. Third derby, he was suspended for the corresponding match last season, which Liverpool won 3-2, their only victory, remember, in the last 10 against Everton. Xavier with a rather uncertain back pass there, Dunn had to step in. Now Steve Staunton. Berger making an excellent run, but it's an Everton throw. Scored in the last 2 home premiership matches, Patrick Berger against Manchester United and Arsenal, and scored in that 3-2 Liverpool win over Everton last season. Well, he doesn't look too delighted, but a very encouraging start for Walter Smith.
Yes, he'd be delighted, Alan, with the opening goal. He preferred it, though, if it was 5 minutes from the end, rather than with 85 minutes remaining. But it's a great boost to his team.
Liverpool threatening with Smitzer again. He's happy for the corner here, he's not going to get it. Liverpool throw. Michael Owen gets his first touch, I think. Hupier. Patrick Berger. Big centre-half has kept going. It's a poor ball, easily intercepted by Hutchison. Berger wouldn't let him out easily. But it's an Everton throw. Talk about Everton's great start. Remarkably, they're actually better off in terms of points at the corresponding stage of the season than they were when they last won the league title. fans have good cause for optimism. Weir. Ball. Bambi. And finding their man, with greater accuracy than Liverpool at the moment. That's a foul. Red nap on Hutchison. The referee will step in and have a word with the Liverpool captain.
Best of mates off the field, Hutchinson and Redknapp, no love lost on the field, two fierce competitors.
Ten minutes gone at what used to be known as Fortress Anfield. Liverpool have already lost twice here in the league this season, a goal down. In towards Jeffers. Hutchison a bit over elaborate, but Everton keep possession. But now they don't. From his mistake. In his second derby match, the Republic of Ireland under 21 international. And Dunn trying to make life hard for Patrick Berger. Fowler's layoff to Owen. Xavier. Vegard Hegger. Spitzer. Aman. Almost got caught in possession again. His obvious lack of match fitness has been pretty evident in the opening stages here.
It's a terribly difficult game for Aman to make his comeback. You know, the pace of the English Premiership is quick enough on a normal Saturday afternoon, but this is a special match. There's not a second to put your foot on it, and he's going to find it terribly difficult.
Had to be something of a risk on the part of Liverpool to play him. He's been out, well, almost 2 months. He's been training back in Germany where he had the operation and the ankle injury. But, no substitute for this kind of dramatic pace. Done in trouble with the referee here.
We have a message from Cathy McIntyre, another to meet Mally on the ticket office. Rise away, please.
Well, Michael Owen being forced to come into a central midfield area to try and get possession. That's because Everton are defending very, very deep. That's the second foul we've seen in the last couple of minutes. One from Redknapp, this one from Dunn. Hit the third time, the player won't be so fortunate. Mr. Riley. A little bit leaning at this moment, but it's not certainly going to continue.
Getting down to 10 men for the moment. Francis Jeffers has just limped off on the halfway line for treatment. Did pretty well without him for the moment. He only wants to come back on. He hasn't caught Mr. Riley's attention yet. Getting back to 11 now. Great kick by Vesterveld. Fowler headed it the wrong way. Owen had just vacated that position. Oops! What an embarrassment there for Gerrard. And it's that kind of little mistake that can give the opposition a lift. Certainly it's given Liverpool a corner.
How fortunate was Gerrard there. 3 yards to his right. And that would have been the own goal, but a disaster of the season.
He's got the Liverpool fans roaring again here. They've been a bit quiet in the opening stages here. They're hitting their own worst enemies with that clearance. Aman. And finally Everton do clear their lines. Ooh, Staunton got a lot on that to give Vesterveld a problem at the other end. But he's a very good kicker with the ball, very comfortable with it in his feet.
Yes, I remember commenting at Leeds when they played away, just how comfortable he is on the floor. He's a wonderful kicker of the ball, and kicks with such power, distance. with great accuracy. You saw just how cool he was there, being put under pressure from a bad back pass from Staunton.
Now Hutchison's given it away, Fowler. That's great defending by Goff. He just used his years of experience to read the play there. Two league games against Sheffield Wednesday and West Ham without conceding a goal. Their first successive clean sheets in the league all year. Liverpool's passing game not yet at its best. Beaten to it this time. Never can get a free kick. There's an angry reaction from Robbie Fowler when he heard the whistle go. Well, no doubt John Hartson's looking at that and wondering exactly what he did wrong yesterday to deserve a second yellow card for a not dissimilar challenge. On by Campbell, but the whistle's already gone. Liverpool free kick. Hammer. This is Staunton. Berger. Fowler delayed his run and enabled Collins to win it back for Everton. Calm play. They wait in here. Final ball from Hutchison gives Liverpool a throw. And Everton have definitely settled the battle of the two teams. The goal, an enormous help. Carragher. This is better from Liverpool. Redknapp, Egan, Bergen and Smits are in the box, being joined by Fowler. Can't get his cross in. And it's Everton who looked dangerous again on the break. Did well to hold it up there, Jeffers. Xavier looking for Campbell. Good layoff. Hutchison. This is done. And Hutchison goes down under the challenge from Staunton. Everton free kick. And a yellow card, in fact, for the Liverpool player.
Excellent positive play there from Hutchison. I don't know quite what the Everton players are complaining about. They've got a yellow card. I think they were after a red.
Referees. Patience just tested once too often there by Steve Staunton. Collins with the free kick. And Liverpool had to rely on their goalkeeper to save them there.
Well, you see David Weir coming at the back post. If it wasn't for the hand of Vestergaard, that would have been 2-0.
Stays in a threatening position in that six-yard box. Hutchinson's kick over Campbell's head, and a great save again by Vestergaard to deny Everton another goal.
Well, he's so quick in the box, Jeffers. Just look how he reacts to this. Comes away off the far post, completely loses marker, with once again an excellent save from Vestergaard.
Liverpool all at sea at the moment. Two tremendous saves, especially the second one there from their goalkeeper. He's kept the score to 1-0. Redknapp, space opening up for the shot. And Gerrard just about got it away, and Fowler from a very difficult angle. Puts it high into the crowd.
Good quick break this from Liverpool. Redknapp onto his right foot. Gerrard pushes it wide, difficult angle for Fowler, tries the snapshot, but gets it totally wrong. This is the chance from Jeffers, and that's an excellent save from Vestergaard. Gets down low to his right, pushes it around the post. But once again, on a set piece, you have to question the marking of Liverpool defenders.
And they're stretched again here. And Jeffers has got Staunton in a bit of trouble. Appeal from the other end of the ground for a penalty, and Vestergaard off the ball had an angry reaction against Jeffers for what he thought was diving then. Liverpool keep giving the ball away, lucky to get it back in this attack. Hegem, Schnitzer, only Owen in the box for Liverpool at the moment. Good tackle by Bohr.
Yeah, it was good defensive play from Bohr. Schmitzer decided he was going to try and use his pace on the outside, have a go at him. But he was equal to it, Ball, an excellent sliding tackle.
Haman. Looked for Owen, couldn't find him. Upio wins it back. Hutchison takes it off him. Xavier. Everton captain in possession again. This is done. Everton in some form of control here at the moment. Midway through the first half, they lead 1-0. It could easily have been even worse for Liverpool. And here's the reason why it isn't.
That's the problem, Alan. He might be the best kicker, but with Owen and Fowler, you have no real presence, no height up there, and the ball just comes straight back.
I think Redknapp's going to be yellow carded here. He got away with an earlier challenge that the referee saw, and getting the ticking off, but not this time. It's his 12th Merseyside derby, this Jamie Redknapp, and he's only been on the winning side twice. Insistent that the free kick's taken from the exact spot. And he's coming to have a word, I think, with Robbie Fowler, yes, because he feels he hadn't retreated the proper distance. Finally, Gerrard delivers it towards Campbell. Good header on, Liverpool in trouble for a moment again.
Yes, that would have been terribly unfortunate for Robbie Fowler if he had been booked, because he actually asked the advice of the linesman.
On that far side getting heated by one or two decisions that have gone against Liverpool, hence the ironic cheers when they get a free kick. Campbell looks a bit bemused as well.
I think the problem with the far side was a high challenge from Schmitzer, which Gough wasn't too happy with.
There's Berger, Fowler, Owen rather, a man, and a Redknapp. Neater football by Liverpool, but it's not in the dangerous area of the field as far as they're concerned.
Problem is, Alan, they can't get in behind the Everton back four. The frustrating them, continuing them to go into feet. They need to turn them, they can't do so.
It's better football though. Come on. Redknapp. Farrell did well with a layoff. Back in to Owen, but much too high for him. Okay.
Excellent build-up play from Liverpool. Fowler out to Smitser. He looks to play the ball in nice and early. The two front players, Owen and Fowler, appreciated that. But it's, as you can see, well over hit. Now to the danger area.
Dunn come to meet it. Everton get a lucky break. Campbell. Are playing a real pressing game in the middle of the field that's certainly knocking Liverpool out of their stride. Poor layoff by Berger. Campbell gets it back to Dunn. Hutchison. Tackle by Hutchison. The cop showed their disapproval. The referee saw nothing wrong. Now Owen. He's got Fowler up in support. And the challenge by Owen.
Yes, it's a bad challenge.
Going to get him in trouble.
He overruns the ball here. It is an excellent challenge from Weir, who takes the ball. Owen realises he overruns it. And that's a bad challenge. You don't like to see that on a football field.
Terribly wound up in the game at times. His anxiety to do well, his anxiety to be a winner, sometimes goes over the top, and he quite literally did then. He was yellow carded.
Yes, there's no place in football that type of challenge. This is a leg breaker, this.
It's a dangerous tackle, I'm afraid to say.
Dangerous.
Some referees would have seen that fitting for a red card.
That's X-rated, that.
That Mr. Riley's been quite lenient towards Michael Owen.
Alan, he couldn't possibly have caught him with the full force of the tackle, because if he had have, he wouldn't have taken any further part in this game.
Here's the earlier incident, Trevor.
This is the challenge from Hutchison, isn't it? Where he jumps in there, and once again, it's high. Just slightly goes over the top to Haman. Well, that's another shocking challenge.
I have to say, justice has been done as far as Michael Owen is concerned, but not as far as Don Hutchison is concerned.
No, the referee missed that one quite clearly, over the top challenge. You mentioned the cops saw it quite clearly. They were incensed. I'm sure Dieter Haman was incensed.
Let's get back to the football, please. The crowd here will not allow anything other than ferocious commitment, and that's what we've seen. But it's got to stay within the laws of the game. It's a poor ball. He was fortunate that Barnby couldn't control it. And Smith's up for Liverpool. Everton are defending well. It's a ball for them. Well, I believe they should have had a free kick then. Redknapp. Knew exactly where Staunton would be. Patrick Berger. Carragher. Hogan's got plenty of targets in the box, but you've got to get the crosses in. Liverpool build up slowly and carefully, but enough incisiveness when they get near the Everton box. And it's given away again to Xavier. Campbell. Collins has gone on a forward run and he's found it. Gone slipped and still got away with it. Gets it back from Xavier. That's a mistake by the young fullback. And he was very glad to see Weir covering behind him. And another challenge there by Smitzer that left an Everton player on the deck, and Campbell is offside. These have never been easy games to referee, and Mr. Riley needs guys in the back of his head at the moment. There's quite a few things going on out there. Sponta. Berger takes over. Three waiting for the cross. It's better this time. With time to deliver a good ball, but it was not Jeffers, it was Campbell ahead of him who was caught offside. Smitzer invites Hegan forward. Moves it to Redknapp. The deflection just took the sting out of the shot, but I think it was quite comfortable anyway in the Everton goal.
Yes, the game plan of Everton is excellent. Solid back four, another bank of four in front of them, giving great protection. And it's making it very, very difficult for Liverpool to try and penetrate.
Nicky Barmby. And Campbell again, embarrassing the Liverpool defence for a moment. And now they break with Fowler. And they've given it away. Everton expecting a free kick once more that didn't come. And Staunton disappointingly overhits the cross, and the Liverpool fans are getting increasingly frustrated and anxious here. So is he.
This is the goal. I think Bobby gets fortunate there. There's nothing fortunate about that. Great awareness. Hupier didn't see Campbell spinning off the back of him. I think it was Carragher who was definitely playing him onside.
Bobby there again. Clever little ball. Campbell, Bobby, and Jeffers in the box. And a number of decisions made by Mr. Riley have upset fans of both sides tonight. Now he's changed his mind. Hagen knocks it long. We are beaten to it. But done there on the cover. He got a bit too much on that though. And Gerrard kept his eye very much on the ball that time. Now by Staunton. He's walking on a bed of nails, having been yellow carded. Chance to break with Smitser. Owen, the only Liverpool man in support at the moment, but it didn't matter because Smitser showed enough of the ball, two ball, and that's going to be at least a free kick, and maybe even another card. The ball becomes the first Everton player caution.
This was definitely a clear chance, wasn't it, for Liverpool. Smitser once again overruns the ball in a good position. Look at it close up. Well, there you can see another very, very high challenge.
And the shot blocked successfully again by the Everton defence. Redknapp, that's a clever little ball. Fowler well placed on the far side. Smits has given it away. A break on for Everton, led by Campbell. It's a good tackle by Haman to stop him. Over by Weir from behind. The referee allows Liverpool the advantage. Redknapp. Again, they got four well placed, but the cross disappointing. Fowler getting angry at the accuracy of the service he's been given. That's gone out. Liverpool throw.
Once again, good positive play from the Everton's right back, Doug. As he went past Staunton, I think Staunton thought about bringing him down. If he had it done, I think he would have seen an early bath.
There's Staunton. Right across this time, but well defended by Everton. Jeffers. Given away to Haman. This is Staunton. Yeah, under pressure from Jeffers. Carragher. Redknapp finds a way through. Great effort by Fowler. And Owen. And still. Penalty. No. But it looked for a moment as though the referee was pointing to the spot. But he has actually waved play on, and Liverpool are under pressure at the other end, and Campbell's well placed here. Jeffers decides to go alone. And maybe that was a mistake because Campbell was perfectly placed. The boos are from the Liverpool fans who feel they've been denied a penalty. And I think they're right.
Well, I can't agree with you, I'm sorry. I think the referee got that right. It's a great shot from Fowler. First mistake from David Weir. Allowed him in. He tried to read it. Fowler got the other side of him. Great shot. Wasn't held by Gerrard. Deflected back towards Owen. Tried to get his shot in. He was overcrowded in the end by two or three defenders of Everton. I'd like to see that again. My first impression that it wasn't a penalty.
Goff getting up well, but his header goes behind for the goal kick. There's another look, Trevor.
With four defenders there trying to get the better of Owen. No, I think he just goes over the legs of, I think it's Michael Ball. Let's have a look at it. Not for me. Not for me. I think the referee got that right.
Certainly made the most of it, Owen. He's given away possession to Dunne. scramble up well, but a good header away by Hupia, who really has settled well into this Liverpool defence. Carragher. Beggum. Berger. Strikers, obviously, and Everton's defence is gobbling it up quite easily at the moment.
Yes, I don't think Everton mind balls coming in from those sort of areas. It's when they get to the byline they have a problem. But I think for Weir and Gough, they're going to cope with those sort of balls all evening. Not a problem to them.
Jeffers for Everton. Bombi down the left, Campbell alongside him. Oh, he twisted and turned the defender. Went for goal. The second time, really, he was a little bit greedy there.
Well, surely Bombi had to be offside there, Alan. He's all of, what, 2 yards away from Vesterbelt when this ball actually comes in. Let's have a little look at it. Clever play again from Jeffers. Gets the better of Carragher. There you can see Bombi following it in. If he got his head to it, sure to have been flagged for offside.
Robbie Fowler, Dunn's clearance, straight onto the head of Hupia. Gough has given Liverpool a problem with that clearance. Good work again by Hupia.
Well, once he allowed that ball to bounce, it was always going to be a problem for him. He had to come and meet it. Once it bounces, it's always a problem for the defender.
Fowler. No free kick. Bombi for Everton. Still lead 1-0 here in the final 3 minutes of the half. And they're looking good again here. Collins is well placed. And they settle for a corner.
For me, Alan, the Everton midfield and the front players are getting at the Liverpool back four far too easily. I spoke about the protection the Everton midfield four are giving their back four. I don't think it's the same with the Liverpool midfield four. Composition of the midfield four, Smitser, Redknapp, Haman and Berger, for me, is far too offensive.
That's the goal opting to punch. Back in from Dunn. Offside. He took the free kick while the ball was still moving. But on Thursday night, there's a UEFA Cup special for you on Sky Digital. Both Newcastle United and Leeds United are in action live on Sky Sports News. Big night of European football, Thursday. Beckham finding Owen. Liverpool's free kick. Now running it out to Smitser. Now Hegem. Not been the prettiest football, but it's always eventful, this particular derby, and it certainly is tonight. Bombi finds Collins, Campbell, Jeff is well placed, lost Staunton cleverly, and couldn't find a way around Sami Hupia. Redknapp spots the run from Berger, can't find it. Does that happen for Liverpool tonight?
But we seldom see a Berger on this left-hand side here. It's been Staunton who's been pushing on, trying to give him the width.
clearance has gone straight to Jeffers. Now Campbell. Campbell made a great break down the centre there, not seen by Campbell. Here's Jeffers for Everton. That was a bit too clever for his own good. And Francis Jeffers, who actually scored in his first ever derby here last season when Everton went down 3-2. Staunton. Campbell goes down from the challenge by Hoopier. Leon says the ref. Smitser. Aman. Staunton has Owen outside him. It's going to take some magic from Owen here to try and pull Liverpool level. Once again, his defence was sound.
Yeah, he's been outstanding, hasn't he, Richard Gough? Owen easily gets the better of Dunn. Just look at the positioning of Richard Gough. Knew exactly where that ball was going to be played. Great defending.
And Liverpool quite happy to get a corner out of that, deep into stoppage time. Carragher has come forward for Liverpool here, so too has Hoopier, the other centre-half. Again, it's an Everton head that beats it first. Another Liverpool corner.
When you look at size, Alan, apart from Hoopier, there's not a great bit of size in there. And look at the Everton players, they must have, what, 7 players, 6 foot plus.
Thornton's kick. It's the first real period of sustained pressure by Liverpool in the half, which has now ended with Everton holding on to their one goal lead, and Gerard Houllier not too happy, I would think, at Liverpool's first half performance here. They conceded a goal within 5 minutes, 4 minutes, 7 seconds to be precise. The public address announcer has just informed me. Barmby, Jeffers, clever build-up play and an unerring finish from Campbell. And if it hadn't been for two great saves, the second in particular from Liverpool's Dutch goalkeeper Sander Westerveld, the situation could have been even worse for Liverpool than the half-time scoreline, which reads Liverpool 0. Everton, who lost their first couple of away games this season, won on their last trip at Sheffield Wednesday, and already showing an improvement on last season when they lost so many times away from Goodison. Liverpool facing their failed the cop end, looking to come at Everton early on here.
So the big talking point half-time was it a penalty on Michael Owen? 1 or 2 points, just leave it there as Jeffers goes clear.
An amazing break again, he's got Barmby up in support as well. Well, you can't accuse him of not shooting enough, Francis Jeffers, can you?
Well, I've spoken about his vision, but on this occasion it let him down, because if he had just lifted his head at the last second, you would have noticed Nick Barmby coming at the far post, totally unmarked. He's obviously not seen him. He's trying to shoot across the keeper. I think he's gone for a throw-in.
Well, no, they like strikers to be greedy, but there are times to be aware of others, and maybe that's the third time in this game he hasn't been.
I was saying, Alan, that Liverpool kicking towards the cop this half. 1 or 2 suggested if Michael Owen had gone down in front of the cop, then perhaps it could have been a penalty.
Berger finds Smitser, who got too much weight on his pass.
I still maintain, having looked at it a couple of times, Alan, but the referee got it right.
It's not been Michael Owen's night so far. Strangely enough, he's never scored a goal either in 4 previous derbies, and he's been on a winning team only once. Helping it on. You have to be impressed the way Everton have defended tonight. Carragher's clearance. Richard Dunn, the 20-year-old Irishman, quite comfortable in letting that go out to give Everton a bit of breathing space. Crowder's layoff. Redknapp being forced wide by the attentions of Hutchison amongst many. And indeed, in the end, the Everton captain fouled him. But if he get on with it quickly, Haman, Staunton. He wasn't allowed to make the cross. Campbell working hard, and that's been part of Everton's game plan tonight. They have given so much to this game. I don't think Mr. Wilde is going to be offered the bungalow on Merseyside by too many of those packed inside Anfield tonight. There's Redknapp. That's skill by Redknapp. Fowler tried to return it. Wheels interception. Another tough challenge. And Campbell this time. Liverpool hunting in packs now. Had possession with Fowler. A large space in front of Carragher, who helps it on to Hegger. Again from the Norwegian international. Owen trying to see where Gough was coming from, but he loses possession anyway. Jeffers, Campbell ahead of him.
Well, that was a great situation again there for Everton, and Jeffers was careless. He knew what he wanted to do, didn't take enough care with his pass. If he played the right ball, Campbell would have been in.
Carragher, Redknapp, Fowler spins away. Smits is just ahead of him again. Liverpool guilty of gifting possession back to the other side. Campbell. She's done. Jeffers has made an early run and he tried to pick him out. Everton feel that Carragher obstructed him. Berger. Did well this time to shake off Hutchison. Redknapp really volleyed that one out, and great skill by Smitsa. Fowler well placed. Well, he must have got the shout, presumably, because he just stepped over the ball. And Everton said thank you very much. And Everton break dangerously again here with Jeffers. The Liverpool defence exposed again. Francis Jeffers is having one of those nights.
Well, that's the second occasion now in the first 4 minutes of the second half that Liverpool have lost a ball in a high position and they've gone clean through them. One pass has put Jeffers clear. Hegum phoned upfield, no cover there, really should have hit the target. They may ruin these chances, Alan. They should be out of sight at the moment. They've had the clear-cut chances, they should be at least two up.
Absolutely. Hutchison. Well won back there by Liverpool. And Owen beaten to it by Gough. It's hard to believe, but he's 37, Richard Gough. There by Campbell, which Mr. Riley has given Liverpool a free kick for. Now they've gone on with it, as they wanted to in the first place. Staunton, Fowler. The ball's just not sticking up front for Liverpool. Campbell offside. Vladimir Smitsev. It was loose as well. Hegum did well. Smitsev gets a second chance and it's a better ball this time. A man dispossessed. Bombi. Hutchison. Fowler worked hard to win it back for Liverpool. On it goes to Redknapp. Staunton to his left, so too is Berger. And again, it was good defending by Everton. Xavier making a vital interception. For £1.5 million from PSV in Holland. Westerveld had to be quick there with Campbell bearing down on him. And the Everton player injured as he fell.
You know why, don't you, Alan, that Westerveld followed through with his boot? He's felt that. Might have to get another look at that. Watch this. Carragher misses it. Watch the foot of Westerveld. There we go.
Well, Kevin Campbell has been a hero to Everton since his arrival last season when he scored 9 goals in 8 games on loan then, before he was signed permanently from Trabzonspor. His goal separates the sides and they won't want to lose him. Well, they always tell goalkeepers to protect themselves, and Westerveld certainly did. Campbell's okay.
Well, 6'4", you're not going to mess with him, are you?
And he's an imposing figure. Schmitzer. Fans want to see the ball played forward more quickly. That's not necessarily Liverpool's style, and that's what happens when it is played quickly. And Goff, under pressure, concedes the throw. Hegem. Berger. Fowler coming to meet it near post, but it's the goalkeeper's ball. And he's yet to beat Liverpool in his short time as Everton manager. Maybe tonight's the night. Foul by Hamann. Well, Hutchison's been in the wars tonight. He can look after himself, of course, but he's been in the thick of those midfield collisions. Goff has gone forward for this Everton free kick. Couldn't win the header. Hegem got there first. Everton in no great hurry. As Michael Ball launches it towards Campbell, it's a foul throw. Lifted his foot off the ground. Looking at Gerard Houllier, and as when his team are going to start performing the way he expects. Fowler. Houllier under pressure from Jeffers did well. Berger. Redknapp. Now Patrick Berger. Typically weaving run from him. And he finds Fowler. Well played, Hutchison. Collins. And that all ends with a Liverpool free kick.
Yeah, it was good play that from Everton. Got good possession, but they just overdid it. Needed the ball to go long.
To the ground there by Goff. I don't know how he got away with that one. Berger has it back, however. And Fowler has a chance. He's got Owen in support. Owen frustrated, but Fowler apparently didn't spot him.
Yes, another mistake this time from David Weir. It's the second occasion now that he's allowed Robbie Fowler in. He has the chance to get the shot in here. It would have been over 25 yards, but they force him wide. His angle gets worse and worse. And it's a comfortable save for Gerrard.
Everton win it back again. Xavier. Bambi. It's a foul. Liverpool had those successive wins against Leeds and Arsenal. Things started to look a bit better. But then Hulier's team were beaten here, of course, by Manchester United. Drew at Leicester. They've already lost three times in the Premiership this season. A home defeat tonight would send out a few warning signals. This a season that was looked forward to with such anticipation by the Liverpool fans, really believing that they could improve on their seventh place last season, their lowest finishing position for 5 years. Well, no doubt that Kenny Dalglish has felt a little more anxious as player and manager at previous Derby games, but he can relax tonight in his Celtic role. Oh, that's a poor ball straight to Collins. Sensible play again, my God. Campbell. And gets it back. Good tackle. Important one from Rupia. Smitsa against Ball, the linesman has flagged, the referee says play on because it would have been a Liverpool free kick, it could be a Liverpool goal, but Gerrard did well at the feet of Robbie Fowler.
Yes, Gerrard did well and also Mr. Riley did well. Linesman, he saw flagging for a foul against Smitsa, but he played the advantage, it was the correct decision. Great run from Fowler, but just slightly overhit from Smitsa, gives Gerrard the chance to come out and dive at his feet.
Staunton plays it early for Berger. And the referee has stopped Liverpool in their tracks because Jeffers is down injured.
Well, he's taken a knock to the head and once again, it's the correct decision. Infuriates the Liverpool supporters. Well, I think that's got something to do with it, the result at this moment. The referee was right again.
Liverpool are about to make a substitution incident. We'll tell you about that in a moment when we look again at this incident. Eric Meyer was ready to come on there for Liverpool. He had his tracksuit off and it seemed as though Liverpool were signalling to Robbie Fowler that he should come off. Maybe he's feeling that ankle again, but Fowler seemed to signal back to the bench that he was ready to continue, at least for the short term. Strange incident that. So Meyer goes back to the bench. Fowler stays on. Smitzer. Given away to Barnby. Collins. Hegem did well. Haman, Staunton, now Redknapp, Jamie Carragher, 11 Everton men between him and the goal, Smitsa's layoff, Hegem with the cross, and Gerrard, apart from that early mistake when he miscued an attempted clearance, hasn't done anything wrong.
No, and Everton as a team have done very little wrong, Alan. The pressing has been outstanding. We've just passed the hour mark. Can they maintain this for another half an hour? And if they can, it's going to be desperately difficult for Liverpool to break them down.
Reminder of our Thursday night European football bill, a UEFA Cup special for Sky Digital viewers, as both Newcastle United and Leeds United are in action live on Sky Sports News. Much better kick by Gerrard this time, so much so that it found Jeffers offside.
Gerrard shaking his head, and rightly so. It was a magnificent clearance on the half volley. There's two front players, Jeffers and Campbell. They're very slow coming back. They should be offside.
Ball cleaning up the first clearance from Goff. Schmitzer didn't realise he had possession. Collins has now for Everton. Xavier couldn't quite release Jeffers. But Liverpool are pushing so many men forward at the moment that you feel that Everton could easily punish them on the counter. Hegem. Now Berger. Fowler. Still looks out of sorts, doesn't he, Robbie Fowler? An ankle injury that has kept him out for the last three games is clearly affecting his game tonight. And I wouldn't think it'd be too much longer now before he is replaced.
When you're a passing team like Liverpool, Alan, they put the onus on passing. It's absolutely imperative that the front players keep possession of that ball. I think Robbie's allowed it to come away from him on too many occasions in this game.
Of course, it was in the corresponding game last season when he got himself into a lot of trouble, not for the goal he scored in the 3-2 win, but for his celebrations, which led to a hefty fine and a lengthy suspension. Well, Maya is coming on now, but it's who's gone off, not Fowler. So there must have been a change of heart on the Liverpool bench. The big Dutchman, who made his first start recently against Hull, comes on. Gerrard is ready to come on, and he, well, obviously, it is a swap. Gerrard will go into midfield, and Maya will replace Robbie Fowler in the end up front. Well, the irony was that Staunton, in particular, in the first 45 minutes, got a lot of good crosses in from the left-hand side. Liverpool didn't have sufficient height or power in the middle to capitalise. Now they have with Maya. Collins. Good tackle by Gerrard. Steph Collins on the ground, but Everton still have possession. Not now, they don't. Disappointing ball by Dunn. Well, substitutions can often change the nature of a game. Ball lay off there by Redknapp, though.
Yes, but it wasn't the best of throws, was it, Alan? The pitch is so greasy. It absolutely flew off the surface towards Redknapp. It's a difficult ball to play. And he put his young mate, Gerrard, in trouble.
And as a result, Liverpool have conceded a free kick. 25 minutes to go. Everton still lead. Hutchinson's free kick, Goff sneak forward, but Westerveld first to it. And immediately gets Liverpool moving. Gerrard. Maya. Gerrard, two substitutes combined. The challenges are typically fierce. And it goes to Maya. Weir defended cleverly. Liverpool's throw. Berger did well to get the ball in, but Collins was on hand for Everton. Now Hutchison.
Once again, excellent play from Hutchinson. Ran that ball a good 30 yards. Picked out Bondi. Played a real captain's role tonight, Hutchinson. An excellent ascent to that park.
Liverpool have had the lion's share of possession in this second half without really seriously threatening Gerrard in the Everton goal. Collins. Barnby leaves it to Campbell. This is Ball. Campbell. Barnby. That's a good ball. Hutchison. Now Dunn. A rare excursion forward for him. Campbell unmarked in the middle. Liverpool's concentration lapsed then. Enjoying a good spell of possession of their own here. Liverpool have Titi Kamara warming up, ready to come on.
Yes, they've been to do that for the last 10 minutes, and they've been working as hard as they have been throughout the game, but when they've won the ball, they've given it away too cheaply. That little spell there, they started to keep possession again, something they did in the first half very, very well.
Patrick Berger. Smitsa, his Czech international teammate. Free kick. Xavier not happy. The referee well placed.
We have a message from Peter Jones of Lurd Street, Birkenhead. Contact the nearest police officer, please.
Staunton knocks it long. Well, the header had Everton in trouble for a moment, but their defending has been top rate tonight.
First time, Alan, from a set piece at Liverpool, had a little bit of joy. It was flighted from Staunton to the back post, and the substitute Meyer got up above Gough with an excellent downward header.
Gough doing rather better this time. But still, Liverpool keep possession. Egan. Again, Hegem, Smitsa, Owen, couldn't get away from Weir. Good vision by Redknapp to pick out Staunton. And then it goes early, Smitsa, the smallest man in the box, pushed to try and make some room for himself, knocked off over, free kick to Everton. And Titi Kamara is about to come on for Liverpool. He's been a big success with the fans in his short time here. He's been out with a groin injury. And that foul was Smitsa's final contribution to the game. And the former Marseille player has a chance to try and save this game for Liverpool. 20 minutes to go.
As we normally expect him when he comes on to play on the left-hand side. Smitsa coming off, he's taken up a right-hand side attacking position.
Liverpool with three out and out attacking players now in Meyer, Owen and Kamara. It's still a goal down. Staunton. Kamara dropped off to make room and then gives it away. Ball's clearance.
Yes, you can see what his intentions were. He picked out the run of Berger and went in behind the two central defenders of Weir and Gough. Didn't make contact.
Collins has given it away here to Hegem. Typically surging run by Vegard Hegem. And Everton have conceded a corner. Gough's clearance. The cop for one of the few times tonight. Let's rip with a mighty roar. Carragher. Gallagher has joined the hordes for the corner, which wasn't very well placed and easily cleared. And remarkably, it stayed in. Jeffers.
And all he can do is hold it up, wait for support. And he certainly gets it. This is a two-on-one situation now.
Xavier. Collins. Well, that had to be made, that tackle, because suddenly Staunton found himself in real trouble.
Yes, but I think Xavier let him off the hook. He's played the wrong ball here. He's got done on his outside. He looks to go inside. And for me, that's the wrong ball.
He has gained Everton a corner. Goff's made a late run into the box. Just beyond him. Barnaby Campbell hit the top of the bar, I think.
Just look at the room that Campbell gets when this ball comes in here. It's quite unbelievable. There's nobody within 4 or 5 yards of him.
Xavier. Campbell's there again. Liverpool get it back with Titi Camara. Lucky to have a second chance here. He's taken it. It's a lovely little back heeler. Patrick Berger couldn't make real progress. Everton breathe again.
Collins did well there. Excellent cover in play. Recognised danger. Quickly reacted to it. The crowd in the cop was shouting for something I couldn't quite see from here. It was certainly good defensive play from Collins.
Remind you of the telephone number to cast your vote for the man of the match. It's 09009 11 22 33. Liverpool in a bit of trouble again at the back. Barmby, Jeffers is onside, offside rather, and he and Vesterveld have an angry clash, and they're both going to be in trouble here.
Well, they've got to go, haven't they? The two of them have got to go off, Jeffers and Vesterveld. It's a pity, but Mr. Riley's got no option. When hands are raised like that, we saw it on Saturday, didn't we, at Derby, Mr. Halsey sending off Huertas. The same's got to happen here. I'm not so sure that he actually was offside. It's immaterial now because it's the talking point.
It's a red card for Jeffers, and it's got to be the same colour surely for Vesterveld. You can tell from the reaction of the Liverpool players it is.
He's got no option, Alan. Hands are raised. Blows took place. He had to go.
Well, Liverpool have got a real problem now because Brad Friedel, who would normally have been on the bench, he's got a lot of experience, of course, as Jeffers continues the arguments going on. Friedel's not here because of this three non-EEC players ruling. And because of that, Liverpool have had to put Jürgen Nielsen, the Danish player, on the bench, and he's never actually played in the first team. In fact, yes, what am I thinking of? They've already had their three substitutes. So they can't change the goalkeeper. Yes, because Camara was Liverpool's third substitute. And Steve Staunton.
Well, he certainly looks to be rubbed up, doesn't he?
So Liverpool's problem, even worse than I imagine. Well, the first challenge by Jeffers was certainly a heavy one, but there was no excuse for getting involved like that. Someone with the experience of Sander Vesterveld should have known better, and the referee was given no option. Things go from bad to worse, it seems, for Gerard Houllier at the moment.
Just
Steve Staunton, the goalkeeper.
interesting to see what Walter Smith does now. Does he keep it exactly the same? Happy with 1-0? Does he try and get an extra forward up there? He puts Staunton under as much pressure as he possibly can. We'll see.
Well, we said these games are always eventful, and this one has not let us down. Berger. Steven Gerrard. It'll be interesting to see if Everton can test the standing keeper now. Barmby. Good tackle by Gallagher. Redknapp. Kamara takes on Dunn on the outside and then the inside. Which way is he going to end up going? Well done, you. Could test Staunton here. Hutchison leading the break. Campbell. Xavier. Back it goes to Campbell. Hutchison's well placed in the middle. And they couldn't find it. Campbell curses himself for not being more accurate.
Here's the first test for Steve Staunton. This is almost his first test. He comes out, dives at the feet of Hutchison. Carragher gets the clearance, goes to the corner, and this is a real test now for Steve Staunton.
Camera up against Dunn again. Good shot of handball there, but the referee had already spotted that. Owen. Everton have really been up for this tonight. They've played exceptionally well. Camara's header. Xavier. That was loose. Straight to Meyer. Redknapp for Liverpool. Bit of a late challenge there by Redknapp on Xavier.
He's got to be careful on it. It was a lunge there at Xavier. Already been booked.
Just thinking it's ironic, isn't it, for Liverpool's third choice goalkeeper, Nielsen, that when he might finally have got the chance to come on, he can't because the three subs have already been used. Yellow card for Goff for taking his time and moving the ball. A free kick. 10 minutes to go.
He is 37 though, Alan. He could do with the rest, couldn't he?
They'll do their best to make sure he doesn't get an easy break in the next 10 minutes. Collins wins it back off Michael Owen. Liverpool's throw. Good persistence there by Owen. Gerrard's cross, it flicked off the defender. Redknapp. Oh. Still the danger as Meyer knocks it back in. And then Carragher. Everton concede the corner off ball. Nine minutes to go. Liverpool nil, Everton one. It came through the crowd. Nobody quite knew where the ball was for a moment. Everton have survived.
Well, they almost got lucky, Liverpool, didn't they? Because it was a poorly struck corner from Gerrard. Straight along the floor. Once again, it comes off Richard Goff's knee, falls straight to one of his colleagues. The intended clearance blocked, goes for a goal kick, relieves the pressure.
Did well. well, but Weir read the danger. Barmby's header. Campbell will keep chasing here. Carragher, the last defender. Staunton can be forgiven perhaps for not fully appreciating the various laws that apply to goalkeepers then.
I seem to recall, Alan, it's not the first time Steve Staunton's actually been in goal. I remember the game.
Hasn't had an actual save to make yet. And Robertson have presented it back to Redknapp here. Gerrard, good ball, Kamara. Not had much joy against Dunn so far. And doesn't again. Big up and under, and Campbell's the man underneath it. That's just the kind of shot that Staunton would have wanted to deal with.
Well, he'll be so disappointed with that effort. You can see what his intentions were. He spotted Staunton off his line, tried to lob it over his head, but it was poorly executed.
Well, it's given Liverpool a break with Kamara. Corner.
And everyone's back for Everton. Leave no one up.
Berger's kick, Carragher trying to get his head onto it, so too did Hoopier. Everton get it away yet again. And Everton have a man down injured at the moment, so
Mr. Riley's ignored it.
Way to go on, yeah. Meyer's shot, and it's deflected! And almost in, corner.
What a great save that was from Gerrard. Great shot from Meyer, I think it was deflected off the foot of ball. Brilliant save.
Hoopier on the far post, never reached him. Meyer made the best attempt to get there. Now Berger. Hoopier's ball in. Strange layoff by Kamara. And the referee's given Liverpool a free kick.
Well, what a big decision that is, because if he'd not given it, Bondi, I'm sure, would have been played clear from Collins.
Redknapp lining up the free kick. 5 minutes to go in the 161st Merseyside derby. Liverpool on a goal down. Well, Gerrard has played his part in this Everton performance tonight.
I think that was less difficult than the one before, Alan. The one before was a brilliant reflex save. I think he saw quite clearly that ball there and enough time to make the save.
Redknapp lifts one in. Looking for Meyer or Carragher, who's virtually another forward at the moment for Liverpool. He's deserted his defensive post. But it's a goal kick.
Well, this is the save of the match for me. Deflected from ball. That really is a brilliant save. Saw it very late, low down to his left-hand side, just got it around the post.
Oh, 9-0-0-9, 11-22-33. Let's hear from you now with your vote for man of the match. Liverpool launch another attack with Hoopier. Hegem. Meyer has called for an early cross. Now Gerrard. Berger. Well played, done. He's had a sound game at right back. Campbell, and suddenly Everton have got an extra man over here. Dunn on the chase. Barmby is in the middle. It's a great run by him, but a fine, fine piece of defending.
Well, that's the danger, isn't it, when you're pushing forward, trying to get the equaliser. They were there at the back. Campbell will let him play the 1-2, but look at whoever this is, Bombi on this left-hand side, totally unmarked. Dunn actually tries to pick him out. But excellent defender from Gerrard.
Just what Everton needed at this stage of the game, a corner that goes in flat to Campbell. Hutchison. Well, if you believe that the team that has most of the possession deserves to win a football match, then Gerard Houllier will say it should have been Liverpool's night. But Everton have defended brilliantly, worked hard, played above themselves in many cases, and are threatening to take all 3 points here. And it would be a hard man that would deny them the right to those 3 points. There's Kamara. Liverpool are not finished yet. 2 minutes to go. Berger's layoff is clever. And back it goes to Redknapp. But Everton get it clear yet again. This really is pressure now. Michael Owen for Liverpool. Bombi back defending. Bit of jostling going on there off the ball as Liverpool prepare to take this throw.
Once again, excellent defending from Richard Gough. He breaks on again if he plays the right ball.
Bombi's in the middle, and this time he has found him, though it was a bit of a difficult ball for him to control, really. Chest high. Into the last minute at Anfield. Liverpool facing the possibility of their third defeat of the season already here. They only lost four matches at Anfield in the whole of last season.
Well, Walter Smith's just gone absolutely furious with the fourth official because he's just seen 5 minutes coming up of injury time.
Hutchison. Yeah, 5 minutes was not what Everton wanted to see. Well, as they've defended. Gerrard. This is Owen. Three in the box here for Liverpool. But there's no way through. Michael Ball is rock solid. No problem for Staunton. He's just had one half-hit shot from Campbell to save so far. Hegum. Everton's throw.
If Everton could defend the injury time and unlike the defender for the 90 minutes, they fully deserve to win. They've been able to do tonight what Liverpool have not been able to do this season, apart from the one game against Arsenal, and that's to keep a clean sheet. And to be fair, they've not really looked like conceding. Their success has been built around a solid back four and a very, very hard-working midfield four who's given plenty of protection, pressed the ball really well all evening.
They've still got some defending to do. Egan plays one in. Berger. Now Gerrard. In it goes again. Bombi did well then for Everton. Campbell takes a clattering challenge from young Gerrard, and it's a red card for him. And the Merseyside derby explodes again here in stoppage time. The third red card of the night. And two of them have been Liverpool players, and there's still arguing, pushing and shoving going on, which the referee will have to deal with. Trevor.
Well, talk about a high tackle. That was almost waist high. You have to say, Alan, that the referee was no more than 2 or 3 yards away from the action. Saw it absolutely clear. and he produced the card instantly.
Well, when you think that he was quite lenient towards Michael Owen, and it has to be said, Don Hutchison in the first half, just think what the red card count could have been tonight.
Yes, it's been fiercely competitive, but over-competitive. Not seen a game for such a long time with so many bad challenges. That's the second time Campbell has caught the one tonight. Earlier, there was one from Vesterveld on him. This one really is high. Just look how high this is. Top of the thigh.
Liverpool reduced to nine men and still a goal down. Collins. Good ball for Barmby. And still Barmby. Oh, good save. Xavier denied what would have been his first goal by a wonderful save from the standing keeper.
Yeah, I think also Xavier denies Barmby a chance here, because I'm sure Barmby would have scored with that. Just as he's about to strike it, Xavier shoots with his left foot. Fair boos to Staunton. He was equal to it.
Everton just need to keep possession now. And the victory is theirs. But Hutchison has lost the ball. Camara charges on. Liverpool have only got one man, but others are arriving from midfield. And it's not a bad ball. Redknapp couldn't get there. Now he could at the second attempt. And Collins on hand to intercept.
Well, that was unbelievably poor play, was it, from Hutchison? He should know better. He's 5 yards from the corner flag, loses possession. And they were lucky to get away with it.
Incredible ending here at Anfield. Goff's clearance. Xavier looks for Barmby. Liverpool have a throw. We're into the final minute, though. There may be a little more time added because of the sending off, apart from anything else. Pumped back in again. Anywhere high into the stand will do now for Everton. Nothing wrong with that. Camara lost his man cleverly.
Once again, Goff in the right position. That ball has been like a magnet to him every time it's come in the penalty box.
Egham. Another throw. The referee's just had a glance at his watch. Berger. And again, Everton, heroic defender, came back in from Redknapp's shot into the crowd. And that might be Liverpool's final opportunity gone.
Well, what a great shot that was from Redknapp on the volley. I think it was Dunn who got the block in. What an important block it was.
Liverpool go back. They've got to go forward at double-quick speed now, though. Weir gets it away. This is Barmby. Campbell. It's all over. A sad night for Liverpool. A great night for Walter Smith and Everton. His first Merseyside derby victory. Liverpool beaten for the third time in a Premiership fixture on their own home ground this season. And just as seriously from their point of view, they had two players sent off, including goalkeeper Vesterveld, who will have to be replaced now at a future date. Everton also had a dismissal in Francis Jeffers. And Everton are celebrating, and why not? It's been a wonderful performance of grit, endeavour, and no little skill from the team from across Stanley Park. They've kept up their wonderful record against Liverpool, beaten just once by their great rivals now in the last 11 games. A tremendous night for Everton, a worrying night though for Liverpool. And as the celebrations continue here, and they will for some time, the final score at Anfield, Liverpool 0, Everton 1.
Paul, incredible game, wasn't it, really? Did you think you could hang on to that early goal?
I don't know, it was tough. It was a great game. I mean, I bet the public loved that game. It was an excellent game.
And everything, didn't it, really?
Yeah, it had a lot. I mean, it's a bit unfortunate for the lad who's just come on to be sent off, but you know, I feel a bit sorry for him.
And the two earlier sendings off as well, no real choice the referee, had he?
No, not really. I think it was just a heated game and there's a lot of passion involved and, you know, both the lads probably deserved to go.
You tried to work Steve Staunton, but he didn't do badly, did he?
He pulled a great save off. He should try and play them more often, I think.
Are you impressed with that, Paul? Steve Staunton in goal?
Yes, he probably did well when he came in, but like I say, a bit unfortunate for Vesterfield to get sent off, but yeah, he did well when he came in, made a great save right at the end.
You had a great night. Do you feel your number one is right now?
No, I think I've got to keep proving myself all the time. You know, I've only had about 10 games, so I mean, the more clean sheets I can keep, the better it is, but I mean, it's great for us tonight, superb.
Three players sent off, and really, it wasn't too bad a game, but the tackles were flying in, weren't they?
Oh, yeah, well, I mean, you expect that in a derby, you know, so. But, I mean, like Don said, a bit unfortunate for the lad who came on to get sent off straight away, but, I mean, you expect that.
What does it say about Liverpool and Everton's position on the table now? Do you feel you're where you are by right?
Yeah, I mean, the table doesn't lie. I mean, we've done superb straight from the start of the season since the Manchester United game. So, like I say, I think we deserve, you know, I think it's fifth we are tonight, so, yeah, we deserve it, yeah.
Balance of power changing on Merseyside, Dom?
I don't know. I mean, you know, both the clubs are trying to get up there where I think they belong. You know, fifth is a great position for us, and we've just got to build on it next week.
And are you going to sign a new contract?
I hope so. Hopefully the chairman will come back after that.
Hopefully you go after this, will they?
I hope not.
Don's the man of the match. Paul, if you can give that to him. Colin Champagne, well done.
Thanks, Woo! Thanks, Paul. Thanks, George.
I don't think you enjoy it during the time, but certainly the result's most enjoyable, which was obviously the most important thing for us.
How pleased were you, Walter, about the way your players went about the way what you asked them to do tonight?
Oh, yes, I was very pleased. I felt the first half hour of the game was probably as well as we played, you know, since I became manager here. And then, you know, obviously Liverpool pushed us back a little bit, being a goal down, and then it got a little bit scrappy in the second half. But I felt the first half hour of the game especially, when we expected to be put under a bit of pressure, we had control of the game.
Did you deliberately send the players out to play at a high tempo, Walter? It seemed to me as if you were happy to concede the ball in Liverpool's half. But as soon as a pass went into your half, you had players round it, you had Liverpool under pressure, you dropped off, maybe not to leave space in behind. Was that all pre-planned? Is that what you set out to do?
Well, I don't know whether it was all pre-planned. I can't say that it was.
But yes.
No, I think the most important thing for us was the way we competed in a match. Uh-huh. We knew we were going to have to compete. As I say, I felt we had by far the best the first half hour of the game, which was an important spell. We managed to get the goal then. And after that, you know, we stuck in. And I felt we were a wee bit unfortunate not to maybe get one or two more.
Tell us about Goffey, 37 years of age. I thought he was absolutely immense tonight. Can he keep going much longer, that lad?
I certainly hope so. He said he'll keep going at the end of the season anyway, but I was pleased for him because a lot of people are saying that when you're signing a player of that age, he's not going to contribute. And he's been probably the best man that we've had in the last few matches.
How far, Walter, would you say you've brought the club in your time there?
Well, we've obviously had a few problems, off the field problems. We've now got a situation where I think we've got a reasonable spirit in our team. We don't have a great deal in terms of people underneath the team if we get injuries or suspensions. But we're at least in there and we're competing at the present moment, which, you know, for maybe quite a few of the games last season when we played the teams who were in the top six, we weren't competing against them. And, you know, I'm very pleased that we've managed to do that in the games that we've played against the better teams so far this season.
You must be delighted the way the players that you've brought in, Walter, maybe over the last 8 or 9 months have settled and really given you probably more, or certainly as much as you expected.
Well, I think they've given us a bit more than we expected. We've been really pleased with the response that we've had. You know, we're only into the first few games of the season, so for us it'll be a matter of trying to keep that going. That'll be the hardest thing for us over the period of the season.
Quick word about the sending off of Francis Jeffers, Walter. Any sympathy at all with the young man?
I felt the two of them got involved, the goalkeeper and him. Both were maybe a little bit carried away with the game, but that happens in derby matches. Yeah. When you're playing in a derby game, you know, the pace of the game, atmosphere on the ground, it brings to that. I would say it would be a good game from a television point of view.
It was.
Incidents that happened, but, you know, I think you have a great deal of sympathy for both the goalkeeper and Francis Jeffers. They do get carried away a little bit.
I think you looked as surprised as we were about the time added on. What did the officials say to you about the 5 minutes that they found?
Well, 5 minutes. I don't think there was that many injuries in the second half of the game. I mean, if we're looking at playing something like 9 minutes overtime counting first half and second half, it's a long time in a game. But in the second half especially, there wasn't that many injuries.
Well, enjoy the night.
Yes, we'll enjoy the night. Yeah. Makes a change.
Nice to talk to you, Walter.
God.